Jesus is God's message to us. Hebrews chapter 1 and verse 1. God, who at various times and in various ways spoke in time past to the fathers by the prophets, has in these last days spoken to us by His Son, whom He has appointed heir of all things, through whom also He made the worlds. God is a speaking God. God has spoken to His people all through the ages. And when we consider the Old Testament, one of the ways in which God communicated His message is through the prophets. God brought forth a word from heaven to touch the lives of His people. And God did this in many, many different ways. Think about Moses. God spoke to Moses through the burning bush. Think about Isaiah. God spoke to Isaiah through a heavenly vision. God spoke to Amos through a basket of fruit. God reached out to Esther through the voice of Mordecai. God sends out messages, and one word from God can change and transform our lives. But as we consider this speaking God, the Word of God reveals to us that God in these last days, and the last days is referring to the age of the Messiah, God has spoken to us in this time through His very Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ, the Son of God, is actually God's message to us. Think about it. God is speaking to our hearts through the life of His Son, Jesus Christ. What does God want us to learn or hear from the life of Jesus? God is revealing Himself through the Lord Jesus. And the message that He's bringing to us is a message of redemption. It's a message of forgiveness. It's a message of salvation. It's a message of healing and a message of deliverance. And God is speaking to mankind through His Son, Jesus, and saying that He has sent His only begotten Son to be our Savior, to be our Redeemer. And so this day, as we look at the Lord Jesus, let's hear the message of the Lord. Let's hear the voice of God speaking through His Son, Jesus Christ. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank You for Your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank You for His life, for His sacrifice, and God, His work on the cross. We thank You for that finished work, O God. And God, this day, we pray that the Holy Spirit will make that work real to those who have never known the salvation of the Lord Jesus. And God, for those of us who are walking in that salvation, we pray that the blessings of the cross be released to us, O God. We receive Your message of the Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.